Now this is a very interesting decorative table, which is a little bit different to the usual sort of thing that we buy. Of course, we specialise in campaign and travel furniture. But believe it or not, this table, with all of its very intricate inlaid marquetry work, was made to dismantle for ease of travel. But we'll come on to that later. While we've got this close up, let's have a look here. We've got George and the dragon, surrounded by a wonderful star design and numerous different types of wood inlaid on a walnut base. So let's draw out a little bit and have a look at the table in the whole. So this tilt top table was made in Sorrento, Italy, in the mid 19th century, and essentially it was made for tourists. Now most Sorrento ware is much smaller and easier for anybody on a grand tour to carry home. We've had Sorrento ware, Brighton Buns in the past, and even a portable travel mirror. But this table was also made to come apart, so it would be easier for the grand tourist to be able to ship it home. Let's have a look how the table sets up, first of all. Now we can have a look at the back here, and we can see the initials stenciled, FL. That's probably the maker. And also written in pencil up here, it says 6,000 to 7,000 pieces of inlay. So that gives you an idea of the amount of time that went into making this piece and the quality of work. If we look down here, we've got a nice ebonized turned column as well, but the column is also inlaid. The foot is a nice silhouette shape, but still a very pleasing shape. And on the top of the foot, we've got yet more inlay. So it's a very interesting, involved table. You might just be able to see at the top here, the screw thread from the column that the top fits onto. Up here, we've got a little fishtail wedge, and that's used to fix the table in the open position. Of course, if it was an English table, it would more likely have a brass fitting. So we can just tip the table there, push the wedge in, and that gives you an idea of how it stands. Nice size as a centre table in a hallway or whatever. Well, let's show you how it comes apart. So now that it's all apart, we can have a bit of a closer look at it. And hopefully you can see on this nicely turned ebonized column, all of the detail to the inlay on these sections here. And of course, the column has got wedge-shaped dovetail sockets so that the legs that have a corresponding dovetail can slide in and lock to make the table nice and stable. So the leg, nice piece of walnut. You can really hopefully see the silhouette shape there. Lots of inlay on the top there. And a wedge-shaped dovetail joint. The interior section of the leg is nice and curved to fit the barrel of the column. And then the bottom of the column, to hold the legs in, you've got another turned finial with a disc there, just to fully lock the table, make it nice and fix for use. But you can also see, hopefully from this shot, how small the table packs down. Now, of course, if you're a tourist, you could easily have this packed up, and it wouldn't take much space in your belongings to take home. And when you do get it home and you are showing off that you've been around Europe on a grand tour, what a wonderful example of your travels to show your friends this table would be, all the way from Sorrento in Italy. Made as a tourist souvenir, not made to come apart for the ease of a soldier to take from camp to camp and set up, but simply made to come apart for the ease of getting it back from Sorrento in Italy to England for a tourist to fit in their luggage. Lovely example of a portable table.